Isn't that special? Snow. Not a lot yet. They say the heavy amounts of it is going to come later this afternoon. It's going to be light flurries like this all day. And then later this afternoon, we are supposed to get heavy snow. It's supposed to end at like 2 a.m. tonight into tomorrow morning. And we should have a total of 5 to 8 inches, they claim. Look at all the leaves here. Because there's still a lot in these trees. And it stopped snow from coming down this area. But one thing we need to do that I should have done already, and I haven't, was put the heater in for the chickens' water so that their water does not freeze. Oh, I can hear them chickens already. So we need cords, and somewhere in here I have the stuff for the chickens. And now I just gotta find it. So here's everything I need. There's a three-way extension cord that runs off that cord right back. And this is what I put underneath their water thing. It's a heat emitter and it keeps their water from freezing. So now I gotta get this done. Well, first things first, clip that heat lamp up there. And I got a little hole that runs through here. Get this cord through here, like so. And then that will go that way. And then, take this sucker here. Move! And then this goes down through this rim, like so. And that just kind of sits in there like that. And then this cord comes up right through that same hole. That over like that, and their water goes back on top of there to keep their water warm. And what I do is I run the cord through there to there, and there's the extension cord, and then I ram these thick insulation pieces in there to close it off, and then I have to stick the one through down at the other end. There is so much stuff growing up on that other side that needs knocked down. But you can see the light in there now. I think these chickens are attacking each other. Go on, get back. Go on. Go. We might have a little problem here. I got one of these chickens that's attacking the other ones. And usually when that happens, that means that's a bad seed and you gotta get that one out of there or it'll literally kill all your other chickens. So, I just kind of broke them up and I can't remember now exactly which one it was, but I'm gonna have to figure it out because that sucker's gotta go. He might be part of Thanksgiving dinner. He keeps it up. She keeps it up. They're all girls. Oh, the life of having chickens. They're like a bunch of, I don't know, kids, I guess, right? But they're going nuts. So it's that time of year. Sometimes they just get a little crazy like that. So I'll watch them over the next couple days and see what happens. If that one is not calming down and still being nasty, that one's gonna go. My oil light has been flashing at me for like a week now, telling me I need to change the oil in the GMC. It's due. So I'm gonna turn that thing around, dump the plow off it, pull it up here, and change the oil. It's lightly snowing, but at least it's not that cold out. So I'm gonna get that done in case we get all that snow later today, which we're supposed to get. I'd rather have the oil changed already, ready to go. All right, I got the oil draining and new filter. Mobil 1 530 oil, full synthetic going in it. But that's gonna take a while to drain. So while this is waiting to drain, watch this mowing clip from yesterday. I saved a little bit from yesterday's video. It was way too long to cut it way down to make a shorter video for yesterday instead of being insanely long. So I got a little left over. So watch this while it drains, and then we'll get back to this. Getting worse out. It's still not really sticking the roads. I mean, it is a little bit in some spots, like on overpasses, bridges, stuff like that, but other than that, it's still not sticking. I've been all over this morning because, well, like I said, I got the oil changed in the truck, and then I topped off the coolant. It was a little bit low, and the tranny fluid was a little bit low, and of course I had three different kinds of tranny fluid in the garage, but none that were right for this truck. It takes Dextron 3, and so I had to go get some of that. I topped it off, and then I went and picked up Roscoe, took him to breakfast, and I just dropped him back off. He's not feeling so good, but so he's gonna sit and relax. I told him, take some medicine, chill out and relax. We won't have to go out until later tonight anyway. So I told him he needs to go sit home and relax and not do anything so that he can start to feel better. Because I've been in his shoes, man. I mean, he's just got a chest cold. It's all congested in his chest right now. But I've spent them days of plowing for hours on end when, you know, you feel like you're gonna puke, and you feel nauseated and weak and just tired and worn down. And man, if you got the poops on top of it, that makes it even worse. So I mean, it's just a nightmare, and I don't wish that upon anybody. I don't want him to have to go through that. So I'm gonna go home, and I'm gonna edit some video and put this up for you guys and make sure all my cameras are charged. I got spare batteries for this one here, and my GoPro Sessions, that's the one I mount right to the mount I have on the dash here for when I plow snow. And that one doesn't take batteries, so I'll just make sure that's fully charged and ready to go. And if I gotta go out plowing later tonight or in the middle of the night, that's what you guys will see tomorrow.
I don't know where you guys are from that watch this, but those of you that watch it that live in snowy areas, this is the kind of crap that we deal with in my area. And I'm sure it's the same in a lot. I don't know if you can see this Monte Carlo in front of me, but his back window is covered in snow. There's no way you can see in it or out it. And he has no lights on. Now, it's a law in New York State anyway, that if it's any inclement weather that requires you using your wiper blades, especially, you have to have your lights on. Your headlights, your tail lights, you gotta have them all on. This guy has no lights on, and he doesn't even have any of his windows cleared off. Probably his windshield, I'm assuming. But you can see here the snow is really starting to stick to the roads and a little bit on the driveways. But this is the kind of stuff we deal with around here. People doing this, and then they wonder why they get in accidents.
Well, I have a bottle of stuff called Slick Mist. It's made by Lucas. It's a like regular squirt spray bottle that whenever we get a crappy snow, I spray my blade down with it, and I spray my headlights and my backup lights because it keeps snow from sticking to it. But for some reason, I can't find it. I had a whole bottle of it. I'll have to go get some more. It's pretty cheap. But in the meantime, because this is all lake effect snow, which means it's heavy, wet, thick, nasty stuff that sticks to blades, it sticks to everything. And it's, it's like plowing heavy, wet mashed potatoes. And so if I do have to go out plowing, that's what it's going to be like. So in the meantime, penetrating oil. We're going to spray this because it's slick enough. Just spray the whole blade down with it. It makes it slippery. And it does really good. It only lasts about one storm. And then it lasts about one storm and then that's it. And then it wears it all off by then. And I'll show you what I mean. My reverse lights are, if you guys remember the video way back when, right there. Because when you're going down the road, and I'm not worried about my headlights, they usually stay pretty good. When you're going down the road and all that snow is kicking up behind you, it packs those reverse lights in. And next thing you know, you go put it in reverse and you can't see anything. They don't light up, so. Well, they light up, but they don't shine back. So this will have to do for now.